Firmware update has been updated to 2.52.22. Let's check out the release notes. But before we continue, I should say that the most awesome thing happened. Once the car finally booted back up, guess what song was playing? None other than Rush's Limelight. So now let's check out the settings. We have... this new release makes it easier than ever for you to take trips in your Tesla. The updated Maps app lets you check on supercharger amenities before you get there. Also, driver profiles are now linked to your key fob, so your car will be set to your preferences before you sit down. Supercharger amenities help to plan for your trip. Each supercharger pin on the Maps app now provides information about amenities. Are there restrooms, restaurants, Wi-Fi, shopping, and or lodging nearby? Automatic driver profiles. Your car now automatically adjusts the seat and steering position for comfort before you get in. Your key to your driver profile, and the car will set the seat, steering wheel, and other settings to your driver profile when you open the door. To enable, go to Controls, Settings, and Driver Profiles. Equalizer settings, you can further tune your sound with two additional equalizer settings. Perfect. Let's check that out first. So we're going to go... I said Limelight, Spirit of Radio. And of course, it reset all my previous settings. So we go up, up, negative 4.5, and now we have two new ones here. Didn't have those before. Do those at number 3, and that should be absolutely perfect. Now all we need is a bowling ball. Next, let's go to Maps. Find us a supercharger. There's little to no signal in this area. I think the closest supercharger on the map should be Pleasant Prairie, right here. Oh! This also starts the incorporation of the idle fee. Never saw that before. Check that out. 40 cent per minute idle fee. Pleasant Prairie Supercharger. Now, unfortunately, while it does have Maps, it does have the icons of what's available, it doesn't actually expound on that. So at this time, even if you were to touch any of them, all it shows is that there's restrooms, food, beverages, coffee house, lodging, shopping, and Wi-Fi available, but it doesn't tell you specifically who or what or where. So, unfortunately, it just tells you that that stuff's within a reasonable walking distance, not that it's actually available immediately or what times it's available. Still, I'll take that. Next, driver profiles. You can link your key fob to your driver profile. And, let's see. Link to key fob 2. Or you can unlink to key fob 2. Apparently, I have key fob 2 in my pocket. I've been using key fob 2 since I got the car. Did not know that. You can have a maximum of 3 key fobs per Tesla vehicle. So if you have 3 drivers, you know, Mama, Papa, and Junior. And the kids will have to share. Now, what would be awesome then if Junior's key fob would also limit the acceleration and speed of the vehicle. That is it. Adios.
Smile, cheese.